Hello everyone, I'm Geoffrey Esch, the postdoc in University of Chile. I'm going to present your work I did in collaboration with Alexandre Bergel, in which we try to identify if the bytecode from an APK, so an Android deployable, was originally written in Kotlin or in Java. The relation between Kotlin and Android. In 2017, the quite recent Kotlin was made official language for Android. In 2019, Android became Kotlin-first. Kotlin is described as a more modern, expressive, and safer language than Java, but it was conceived in Java interoperability in mind, so it's quite easy to call Kotlin code from Java and Java code from Kotlin, and they both can run on the same virtual machine, Kotlin the one from Android. And from the new functionality of Kotlin difference, you have type inference. By default, you have non-nullable reference, data classes, coroutines, which are now the recommended way to do asynchronous tasks in Android. For the adoption of Kotlin on store, we have some number from Google. We can see that 60% of the top apps contains Kotlin code. App brand gives some so information about the top apps. We have to see a larger adoption of Kotlin in top apps with 75% of them and only 50% of them with overhaul apps. It's easy to know if an app uses Kotlin because you will find in the APK some bytecode from the standard Kotlin library in a Kotlin folder, but it's harder to know what the proportion of the code or the library actually were written in Kotlin. It can be just one class in the APK, it can be one class from a library or just some other library with dependencies which are using Kotlin, and you would see, okay, this app uses Kotlin, but it doesn't say you what proportion of the code was written. We have some work in operational applications, so with the source code it's quite easy to see if it was written in Java or Kotlin. The first one, they identified 20% of the app featuring Kotlin. In another recent work, they, with a bit more apps, they identify less apps, like around 11% of Kotlin apps, but they saw that there is an increase in proportion in each of these applications over the year. Now we want to know what happened on the store. You can take any application, or you can know what's the proportion of code written in Kotlin. So for this, we need to know if we can differentiate Android bytecode in the bytecode if it was originally written in Kotlin or Java. And we want to look at what's the proportion over the year with this. Kotlin bytecode will usually include metadata annotation at the top of the classes. So it's quite easy to identify, but the fact that there can be obfuscation make it harder because this annotation could be removed, could be a bit modified. So if an app uses an obfuscator like ProGuard or another obfuscator, it's harder to identify like this. So we want you to try doing like TF-feed IDF, so looking at the frequency of the word over the overall frequency of all keywords, and using some machine learning if we were able to identify, okay, this code was originally written Kotlin on Java. So we created a learning dataset based on the apps available in F-Droid. We found 300 of them featuring Kotlin, and some of them were also using ProGuard for obfuscation. So we needed to map the source code and the bytecode, so taking the APK available on F-Droid. And for the source code, we took the tarball of source code available from F-Droid, but in some case, we needed also to build the apps. So we were able to build most of them, the apps using ProGuard, because we needed the mapping file, which, okay, this class has been renamed, obfuscated using this name. We decompiled APK using APK tool to get Smiley, which is like quite readable with some keywords. And we got a dataset of more than 50,000 Java classes, which we balanced to the number of Kotlin classes to have a dataset allowing us to do the TF-DF and machine learning. For the future of our model, we made a dictionary of more than 300 keywords, which we made available online. So we have the basic keywords you can find in the bytecode, like move, public, go to method, well, what you can imagine. We also added like exact desimal value because the access flag, for example, in Kotlin, we know that the class will be by default final. So we want the access flag tell you, okay, this class is public, final, static, or private. So the value would be, for example, 16, 17, or this kind of value. So we added some hexadecimal values. We added other keywords. For example, there is companion object for Kotlin. Void is by default replaced by unit. So we added this keyword. Some also keyword related to package to see if an app, for example, use Kotlin standard libraries as a standard library. If there is some stuff we can get for the line number or the source code, this kind of stuff. And we apply just on this model of the TF-EDF, we apply some machine learning. So we try different algorithms. We can see that the random forest was really the more adapted for this kind of problem with an info score on more than 0.96. So it was really more than what we expected at first. When we look at the feature well selected, with no surprise, we can see that there is some specific keyword like Kotlin, GVM, the metadata I mentioned, the access flag. There is some other keyword like, I don't know, synthetic, private, throw, which are common to both language, but they appear at different frequency. For example, the check too, because there would be a check if you want to do some cast from a Java class, this kind of stuff. I should mention here that we got similar result between obfuscated and non-obfuscated apps. Sometimes the order of keyword in feature importance change, but overall that's the same keyword. And because sometimes obfuscation is not complete too, but overall the result for precision and recall is the same, at least for random forest. And we did a preliminary study. We selected apps from the Android dataset, which contained millions of apps between January 2017 and December 2020. And if we look at this dataset, we can see that overall the number of classes overall in apps grow over time. I should mention here it includes libraries. And our results. So the number of apps is growing over time. We are still a growing data set, but we can see that app featuring Kotlin really grow over time. It's quite impressive to see it went from nearly 0% to 70%, which is similar to what we can assume in app brain statistics. If we look overall on the apps, the percentage of Kotlin classes is growing too. It's not so much, but it went from nearly 0% to 5% overall. And if we look at apps using Kotlin, also it's growing. We can see at first in 2017, very few apps use Kotlin, but they were using Kotlin in large proportion. Whereas after the next year, it was like adopted by more apps, but using still part of Java code. But now it's growing, and it will probably grow in the following years. If we look visually at this, we can observe this really that the proportion of code is growing. So it can be the minimums, the maximums, the quartile, everything is have the tendency to grow over time. The proportion of Kotlin codes in apps, in Kotlin apps. In conclusion, in this short paper, we presented the price size model. I want to get an insight of the steady absorption in Kotlin. We confirmed some results. We also saw that the adoption is faster in popular apps, like from what we can observe from app-based statistics, but it's also true for the proportion of code. These apps contain more proportion of Kotlin codes. We really encourage the community to consider Kotlin for future study. We also, in the paper, we show that in the conference, Kotlin was a bit not really looked into by many people. It's not mentioned. It's not mentioned in the threads validity if it applied to Java. I'm very glad to see that there is a session at MOBILESoft dedicated to Kotlin. I think for future work, we need at least to consider it, or at least to mention it in the threads if it's not considered. And for our further work, we want to see our apps integrate Kotlin over time, or the quality is affected. We also differentiate the code if it came from apps, from the app source code of libraries. And thank you for your attention.